grande.
Hello? Just arrived? Peggy?
Anybody home? Just arrived. I'm coming.
Ah, Rose, what are you doing here?
Oh, hello there, Justin Rice. How you doing?
Hey, nice hat. I'm doing fine.
Yeah, I've got a new hat, yeah.
Looking pretty good, you know,
Sorry I barged in here, but you know,
No problem.
I was down in New Jersey visiting Ross and Felice, my friends, and Susan, the writer. She's a good writer, you know. I had a nice visit, and I thought, I better go out to the Pinto Pony Ranch.
Oh, yeah, well, welcome.
So I got in my car, and I drove all the way out here.
Yeah, that's a long haul.
And my car broke down.
Oh, my goodness, that's terrible.
3 miles from here, Jesse,
right? Oh, my goodness, you should have called.
This is wilderness out here.
I know it. It's terrible.
Anyway,
the weather's bad, too.
I thought maybe Sammy Labatchi was out here.
No.
You know, Tony's younger brother.
Well, I know him, but
he went missing a while ago.
I know. Well, he's not here. I haven't seen hide nor hair of him. I've got to get going now.
Oh, so you knew about
it? Yeah, I knew about it, yes.
Well, you know, Regina's in Bermuda looking for Sammy, but I thought maybe he might come out here to Pinto Pony Ranch.
Well, no, he hasn't showed up yet, and we're kind of recording here now, Rose, and I got to get back to
it. So you've been recording,
yeah,
eh? Well, it's Peggy Lombrowski here. I'd love to have a word with her, you know?
Yeah.
She might know something.
Well, she's doing the final vocal track, you know, and I kind of...
Could you get it for me, you
know? I'll get it for you. Peggy!
Freezing out there. I saw better.
Yeah, terrible.
The car broke down and 3 miles walking. I'm tired. You have some hot chocolate, maybe?
Maybe I can make you some grub later after we finish. You
anyway, you know, I think that Sammy...
Yeah.
We didn't notice when he disappeared right off the bat, because, you know, he's always going out to get us lunch, you know, putting in the replicates. We need coffee. There he goes. He goes and gets
nice
it,
guy.
You know.
Helpful feller.
Well, maybe Sammy...
Yeah.
Maybe Sammy has dreams of his own.
I bet he does.
Like, there's a little bit beyond when you get coffee, you know?
Yeah, I think he might want to sing or dance or something, you know, but I'm going to go, Rose.
Well, hi there.
Hello there, Peggy. How
I'm
you doing?
I'm fine. Nice haircut. Is that a new hat?
Yes, I got my hair cut. So big deal. Yeah, it's a new hat. What do you want? Make a big hubbub about that? It's just me, Rose, you know.
Well, I'm so sorry. Did grubbiness get you where you want to go? Did your grouchiness and grumpiness ever get you where you want to go?
Did my grumpiness and grouchiness ever get me where I wanted to go? Well, not really.
What?
Listen, I'm stressed out.
I see that.
We've got to get to the bottom of this. Simon's been missing.
I know that.
We didn't even notice he was gone for the longest time. Because he's always going out for coffee and sandwiches for Penny and the Replicas. But you know what?
What?
You know what, P? Piggy Lumberskins. I think Sammy has dreams of his own.
Well, I don't blame him, you know.
We've got to find
him. I'm really going to get back to this vocal book. See, we're going to find out what happened to Sammy Labatchi if it's the last thing I ever knew. It's going to come before the music. It's going to come before everything else.
Like a rodeo bull, kicking up dust and danger. Nobody here's gonna rope you in. I better call the Lone Ranger. Just a flash of red that caught my eye, but you dragged it too far. I tried to steer clear, but you caught my heart. Well, no, don't you drop it, don't leave it lying around. Please long before it hits the ground. I'm hoping that a broken heart ain't something that you delight in. Cause honey, my heart is a breakable item.